Hai, Assalamualaikum dan salam sejahtera. Kamu dah bersedia? Jom, kita santai-santai belajar fizik. Jom kita start. Okey, subtopik hari ini adalah 1.2 Scalars and Vectors. What is scalar quantity? Scalar quantity is defined as the quantity with magnitude only. Magnitude means that value or number. For example, a car moves for 30 km far, so 30 km is represent magnitude. Other physical quantity for scalar quantity is distance, temperature, mass, speed, and more. How about vector quantity? So vector quantity is defined as the quantity with both magnitude and direction. For example, a car moves for 30 km far to the north. 30 km is the magnitude. And the north is the direction. Other example for physical quantity for vector quantity is displacement, velocity, force, momentum, and more. So next is illustrate unit vector in Cartesian coordinate. As you can see here, I cap, J cap, and K cap is represented as the unit vector notation. Maksudnya, dia mewakili komponen X, komponen Y dan komponen Z. So, as you can see here, we have the Cartesian coordinate for X component, Y component and Z component. The red arrow is show you the vector for notation I for component X, notation J cap to component Y and K cap to component Z. Unit vector is a vector with magnitude of 1, no unit and parallel to the coordinate axis. I cap is represented component x and they are parallel to x axis. Next, unit vector are dimensionless, means that no unit. So I cap, J cap or K cap is equal to 1. Number 3. Unit vector is used for pointing and showing direction. If let's say the unit vector component x is positive x axis, so the value of unit vector is positive. Vector can be written in terms of unit vector as rx I cap plus ry j cap plus rz k cap. It's represented by each component. So kita ada contoh dekat sini. Jom kita tengok. Vector in two dimension, kita ada point 3 dan 4. 3 adalah komponen X, 4 adalah komponen Y. Maka, vector yang kita tulis adalah 3 I cap plus 4 J cap. Kalau dalam 3 dimension, kita ada 2, 3 dan 5. So, kita akan tulis dalam form 2 I cap plus 3 J cap plus 5 K cap. Okay, so state the physical meaning of the dot scalar product and the cross vector product. So apa yang ada dalam dot scalar product ni? Kita ada vector A dot vector B is equal to magnitude A times magnitude B cos theta. A dan B is a magnitude and theta adalah angle between A and B. So cross vector product adalah vector A cross vector B will become out as a new vector, vector C. Or you can write as vector A cross vector B is equal to AB sin theta, whereas A and B is a magnitude and theta is angle between A and B. So here example for magnitude of A. Given vector A is 3 I cap minus 2 J cap. So macam mana kita nak cari magnitude dia? Kita kuasakan 3 kuasa 2 tambah negative 2 kuasa 2 dan kita akan punca kuasa. So we get set 13. So dot scalar product adalah scalar quantity and cross vector product is a vector quantity. Vector A and B must be parallel to each other. If they are not, resolve either one to make them parallel. Contoh, A sekarang dan B tidak parallel. Maka apa yang perlu kita buat? Kita kena resolve vector A kepada vector B. So dia akan jadi A cos B. Sorry, A cos theta. So now A cos theta is parallel to vector B. For vector quantity, vector A and B must be perpendicular to each other. So when A cross B, we come out as vector C going upward because we can see that the thumb is going upward. So direction can be determined by using right hand grip rule. Example of the dot scalar product is work because F dot S come out as F as cos theta. So example of cross vector product is the top. Top is equal to R cross F will be RF sin theta. So, macam mana? Agak mencabar juga kan? Tapi tak apa, kita boleh belajar lagi dalam tutorial. Okay, jumpa pada next subtopik. Bye!